This is a short video on the organs pilot within the Polyphonia project. My name is Peter van Kranenburg. I work for the Meertens Institute of the Royal Netherlands Academy of Arts and Sciences in Amsterdam. And in this video, I will explain the expected outcomes of the pilot project and how they can be of importance to various stakeholders. So the aim of the pilot is to design tools and data structures to make large amounts of historic data on pipe organs digitally available. For the contents, the focus is now on the Dutch Organ Encyclopedia. It makes sense to use that as a starting point because this data set is coherent. It is well curated, well edited. It is partly structured, which eases the initial data extraction. But we plan later on to design the tools and the data structures in such a way that other sources can be connected. Organs from other countries, other traditions, information from other sources like journals or newspapers. But for now we focus on the Dutch Organ Encyclopedia. The result of this pilot will be important for the study and preservation of historic musical instruments. Not only organs, but also other instruments. We study historic instruments for various reasons. One is the historic performance practice. The way the instruments are built learns us something about the way they have been played. And if we are interested in playing early music, the instruments are a rich source of information. But also we study instruments themselves. If we want to reconstruct or rebuild a certain early instrument, or we want to restore an instrument, we need of course historic information. The organ is a special case because most organs are not in musea, but are in churches and concert halls, for example, and they are currently used. That means that an instrument that is in use needs to be maintained. So they are also continuously maintained and continuously reworked and adapted to changing musical insights and changing musical taste. Because the organ is so complicated, both technically and historically, we expect that the data structures and ontologies we will develop within a pilot form a very good base for comparable information on other instruments. Currently, the pilot is in the first phase of knowledge extraction. Well, that's basically done. So of all the organs, we have basic historic information, basic technical descriptions, which already provides us with a rich data set of information. And also the first iterations of the ontology are done. And these will be made available in a demo interface later this year. The results of the pilot are of interest for various stakeholders. First, there are organ builders. Organ builders both build new instruments and restore existing instruments. And for both kinds of projects, the access to a data collection on existing organs is of importance. Another group of stakeholders are organ advisors. Organ advisors are experts who are involved in a restoration project. They have to write a report and do suggestions or make a plan for a restoration. And in making these plans, of course, it's of crucial importance to have information on comparable, similar organs available. Because other organs might contain parts that are lost in the organ that is being restored, so it can be reconstructed, and other organs can be taken as an example for the efficient restoration. But also governmental institutions can benefit from the results, especially of course cultural heritage departments. Also music historians and organologists, so the academic users, can benefit from the result of this pilot. The resulting tools will make possible to trace historic developments over time or to find connections between organists, organ builders, the ways organs were used. So that's important or interesting from a music historical point of view. And there is a general public of organ enthusiasts. And for them, the pilot will deliver a nice exploration tool in which information on organs can be found, for example, in preparation of visiting an organ concert. So that, in short, is the aim, the importance of the pilot, the state of the current state, and the various groups of stakeholders for which the pilot is of interest. Thank you for listening.